Land-based closed containment salmonid production represents an important and growing sector of the overall aquaculture industry. These land-based operations utilize water recirculating aquaculture systems, also known as RAS technologies. RAS can provide numerous benefits, including enhanced biosecurity, increased optimization and control over the fish rearing environment, effective capture of waste, no interaction between farmed fish and wild fish populations, and reduced overall carbon footprint by providing increased domestic seafood availability close to local markets. Support for research and technology development is needed to facilitate the growth of this sector and is vital to meet U.S. seafood demand. Continued research and development in closed containment aquaculture production will also facilitate domestic agricultural economic contribution, job growth, and food security. Based on current knowledge, there are several significant technobiological challenges encountered when rearing Atlantic salmon in land-based systems. The University of Wisconsin Stevens Point Northern Aquaculture Demonstration Facility, also known as UWSP NADF, along with partners at the Conservation Fund Freshwater Institute, have been funded by the National Sea Grant College Program to investigate means to reduce or eliminate two significant barriers outlined by the industry for raising salmon in RAS and ultimately enhancing the economic viability of RAS operations. One barrier investigated by the team involves managing opportunistic pathogen infections, specifically saprolegniasis, a fish disease caused by a common fungus, which is most prominently observed at early life stages. This disease can quickly lead to fish illness and mortality if left untreated. Effective therapeutic strategies must be developed not only to reduce losses due to saprolegniasis, but also to maintain adequate water quality for fish health and performance, and not impact RAS biofiltration capacity. To investigate treatment and prevention, researchers are currently evaluating whether saprolegniasis is reduced with the use of two common and environmentally benign water treatment chemicals, parasitic acid and hydrogen peroxide. This project is investigating the optimal, low dosage of these therapeutics while maintaining fish welfare for effectively treating and preventing saprolegniasis at specific early life stages. Generally, during the pre- and post-smoltification stages, fish have increased vulnerability to disease. Smoltification is a natural, complex series of physiological changes where young salmonid fish adapt from living in fresh water to living in seawater. During this stage, fish may have reduced immunocompetence, leading to increased vulnerability to pathogens and disease. The development of therapeutic approaches to combat disease issues such as saprolegniasis would be highly beneficial to the industry, for salmon raised both in hatcheries for restocking efforts as well as salmon raised in RAS facilities for food production. The second barrier investigated as part of this project is ensuring the optimal flavor profile of market-sized food fish prior to harvest. In various culture systems, fish fillets can accumulate an earthy or musty flavor, also known as off flavor. Off flavor is commonly due to the chemical compounds created by a certain species of harmless bacteria that can accumulate naturally in aquaculture systems, especially RAS. These off flavor compounds primarily enter the fish by uptake through the gills. Fortunately, these compounds can also be diffused out of the gills upon transfer to a single pass, clean water system for a number of days. This process is referred to as depuration or purging. While this method of depuration is effective, it also requires additional time, energy, and space. This project will investigate various practices, such as managing flow rates and increasing fish ventilation rates by manipulating swimming speeds and oxygen levels to shorten the purge time, thus saving substantial time and space at the commercial farms. Research for this project is being conducted at the UWSP NADF and at the Conservation Fund Freshwater Institute in West Virginia. Other project partners include the University of Wisconsin Sea Grant Institute and private industry partners Superior Fresh and Riverence. For outcomes of this project and deliverables, please visit aquaculture.uwsp.edu.